A lot of times people see battles and skirmishes on TV and they say, aha, the revolution is being televised. He says, no. The revolution, that, those are the results of the revolution. The first revolution is when you change your mind about how you look at things and see that there's another way to see that, that you have not been shown. And so I hope that this event will show you enough.
how many have heard DIA?
It is
Defense Intelligence Agency.
CIA and FBI combined. The
intelligence agencies in the community, and all but I think two or three of them are military intelligence. There's Army and Navy and Air Force intelligence, advanced intelligences. There's the National Reconnaissance Organization, now called Interspatial Geopolitical. This is five satellites. The NSA, National Security Agency, that's under the military, always has been. The largest internal police force in the United States, Defense Industrial Security Command, is under DIA, started to guard the Manhattan Project. This is really the beginning of the loss of civil liberties in this country, because the special provisions were made for the development of the bomb, aggrandizement of power into the executive branch, excessive secrecy, and a permanent war economy and a permanent emergency economy came out of the development by Groves and others, John Groves of the Manhattan Project. And the DIA implements what the CIA thinks up. The CIA doesn't have the troops in the plane. They want to do an assassination of two abroad, they have to remove the CIA. And most of that is carried out by NASA. You can find 600 books on the CIA either. 75 on the DIA. I know two on the NFL, but they're from the same author. It's not written about, it's not talked about, but that's the intelligence network that we live under day to day. Cynthia asked me to start off talking a little bit about, you know, a little bit about Jonestown. Jonestown is also a political assassination, not only a mass political assassination, but as a movement of political assassination. It's known because it was the first member of Congress who was killed in line of duty. Congress Murray Rowe Ryan. He was in the Central Airport of Cartoon. And shot by about people who the witnesses said acted as if they were controlled somehow. They had no emotional assets. And they shot certain people, you know, they went person to person. And we're looking at the faces to find a good fit. So we chose to select. And Ryan, among other things, has been the first one to go down to take a look at Jonestown to see what was happening there. But he was also the author of the Dean Rowland Amendment, which, had it continued, would have forced the CIA to reveal to Congress all of the federal activities and events in the view. for those open orders. To the wrong places, let's do the pathology, saying, why didn't you do the forensics on these bodies and find out what the cause of death was? And the answer is, let's do the pathology, and the third part, back to them, was you could have died. 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 You could have died.
But you don't find that out by reading the
knowing that there are two governments operating in this country, one visible, one invisible, and I grew up in Boston, Virginia. The Baltimore and the veteran community of the CIA, the NSA, the CIA, the Pentagon, and my parents were civilian employees of the Pentagon for many years. And, I realized during that time that things were happening that we knew about and things were happening that we didn't know about. I imagine my first political crisis with the government line was with U2 incident, where a spy plane went down in Russia, and they were forced to admit that it wasn't a weather plane, it was actually a spy plane. They passed through the pilot, the plane, and they had the good landing. But that meant that we, like the dirty Russians, were also spy and were also lying to the government. And that was shocking. But I guess the main thing that turned me into all the time researcher was the assassination of President Kennedy, which is something that I don't know how to compare it to this generation, except perhaps 9/11. How it struck anyone in my generation, and some more than one of them. I went first to the right, well, I read it first. Well, let's just get it. I thought, how do I let this stuff go to school and take the volume? Then I went to the record. I went to the president's volumes. I read in my library at the campus at night from a clean group that was studying all night. And I read the president's volumes on the third of the report, and they didn't match the report. The report made it didn't match. And I'm sure now that we finally have the official investigative record being released all the time later from the 9/11 Commission, that we were similarly found that their actual investigative file. The conclusion, because neither report was written by the investigative team. The narrative of the 9/11 Commission was written by a guy named Timothy Lawford, you know, I tried to run a blind spot and shared on this because, you know, he didn't have the intelligence. He had intelligence failure. And it was written prior to the situation. The war report I eventually found out was written by two people sent over from the Pentagon. And ran in the Standard Division on a temporary duty order to write the report. And then I found in the files up at the archives that one of them was going to resign because they were back in to recruit for stuff that they didn't have available at the archives afterwards, which was even before these recent releases. But they were line by line critiques of the five investigative staff saying, where'd you get this? What's this based on? What's the evidence for this? So the investigative staff, similarly, in the commission, when the commission released two of the investigative staff reports, they put a disclaimer. I went to a meeting in that one commission, and they put a disclaimer on the show. Well, the commission has read this report in both its public and adapted form, and we have gone through this report in our conclusion, but this is not an official document of the 9/11 Commission. So their own investigative staff reports are not their official document. That's not what they want me to know. Read the report. And the two people, of the two people that came over from the Pentagon, one was a guy named Rudolph Otto Winnicott, who wrote the Warren Commission report on President Kennedy's assassination. He had been one of 26 assistant historians during that paper. He and other historians were brought under the cover of Joel McCarthy and the G2 staff, who was also trained in the Prince Academy and was in the analysis. Kurt Wiesenthal, who used the name John Willoughby as cover, and they were brought into the Pentagon Records Division. And one of them was still there all those years later. He was in his 90s and still hadn't retired. And he's the other guy that worked for the Warren Commission, but his name is Isaac Goldberg. And he's the main person listed on the official Pentagon report on the 9/11 report. So he's still writing reports, all these years later. For what they were. So, when I went to the record, I found it out. I said, it's missing that I went and found the famous critics. I read some of the books in the college library area where he was going now, because I couldn't find them in my local library. And I met them, and I worked with a lot of the other critics, and followed the case, and tried for years to get a particular. In 68, when Dr. King was killed, I had already been doing an allergic work in my practice, and I understood the significance of Dr. King and followed him as a life. I worked on my goals, which is to reduce the power, and so I went to let's go out and find a citizen of Robert Stone. And I began to look into his assassination. I remember the night that Bobby Kennedy was killed. I was watching the crowd at the Ambassador Hotel on the road.
Well, okay, then I'm an irony theorist, you know, but I think it might be
this is a plan that says it was done with the
so all division, this is another problem with taking a left structuralist view. I did a partial work on the effect of magnets. From the system forward, we were able to hold a few conferences in Florida after they survived and offered up to the center. This is the story of Ottoman agreement to them. And while there were elements of the religion that we used in the assassination,
down the pipe.
they got lost out into the open. And when you do that, you can find them. And they got, you know, like the guys, you know, like they got, you find out, passes in the open, find the black box disappears and the floor disappears. That's the time you're talking to the city of East Dallas, the city of East Dallas, the city of
So you need to come back. And I'm going to say, this story,
on the floor, you know. And now we have so far up and we have to go up a window down to the top, you know. And yet, even though they saw the picture, some of those, the room is not consistent with that. And so they memorialized the law. The six ones were said that they wanted to be dignified, they wanted to have a carnival atmosphere. My carnival atmosphere is holding some banners up, holding them in songs to speak to the power. You guys carnival? But if you guys want to lose, they're calling them more than representative circus. Well, if I'm a circus, then the guys speak in a circus of songs. But they want to do the same job. Okay? And, but they don't want to do it this year because there are 10,000 people this year. Because they're not in the appendix. So I started to call here and occupy the job today. So it's just too. But they don't have a lot of time to come up with a lot of money. But we need to be there when it matters, not with everybody. And in the middle of that, he said, the only one who goes to the summer goes to play summer first. And he said, it doesn't have to be that case. He just happened to put the time to play. We're going to talk about that later, but we're going to talk about that. You can talk about that, but it's nature. You're going to take the day that dies, and you're coming to something that's still off of you. You don't want to put a thing in front of you. You're going to just have to death, though. We're going to talk about death. So how can we talk about his life if it's going to be death? What does his life mean if you don't understand why he's scared? They want you to see Dr. Curtis Grossman, especially when he's in the world, saying he has a dream. And all of a sudden, years later, in 67, a Riverside Church saying, we're in the war in Vietnam, and black used to exist. They don't want to say, let's take the people's march and occupy D.C. and set the city down until we do something about poverty. Poverty is when he's going to work with us. Well, no, it's nothing. They're not the government up in New York, and now he's just talking about here. It's all the reason we're fighting the government in that place, and he's going to combine with Dr. Church. And both of them are working. The
of your present and your future as well as our
Or the assumption that a president is, in, you know, is an all-knowledgeable person, or that person has a lot of information that has access to. And I'm actually also thinking in the context of the whole 9/11, right? Then what does that become? You know, who was the person who was in power, or who authorized that? That's one observation that I wanted to say. I mean, another, a second observation, it doesn't really. I think we have an image of our country, or of this country. I mean, I'm talking as a person who's also come to this country quite late. And it's kind of like the Catholic Church. We have one, you know, this is how we want people to perceive us. But then we've got all this crap underneath us. And I think, you know, we just have to contend with that reality. And coming from another perspective, I know that the U.S. has been involved in the political killing of so many other people in other countries in order to maintain a certain status. And it actually is connected to our way of life, because it's actually reflecting as long as the good continue coming to us, this is what is shutting our society down. You know, really being close to, because our life is not being threatened.
Well, our lives are being threatened. But and I hope that's the message that is received here. It's a way of life that never happened, that has been threatened.
What I'm saying by that is exactly, and we know that, but 99.9% probably of population of this country does not know that, and that I've stopped there.
And there's also something called responsibility. The person in office has responsibility to know.
Thank you. Is there any way a link for the mysterious death of Whitney Young, a death that very odd with common players, Jesse Jackson nearby, and he gets an undertow and drowns, a good swimmer. Is Whitney Young's assassination another one of these? If you have any information on that.
Well, actually, Randy knows more about the, that's Randy.
What was that 4 years ago? Organizers to kill coming into power. Stalin was given a similar list by Beria, who has been the head of intelligence for the czar that stayed on in the czar. This is all they have. You know, you asked about Gresley. Gresley come and go. The CIA, the DIA, and the Pentagon, get them drunk. And so they're all with half them tonight. When you're general, you just stuff them down and do a bit for them, you know. So it's certainly not outside my work to look into the depth of performance and people who are sensitive to it, and reading a lot of it.
These almost fit the bracket of the well-known official group Black American assassinations. And he certainly would have been someone that could have been a vice presidential candidate or anything else, and he suddenly disappears.
Well, Andy,
and of course,
King,
they killed him in
Andy King's death I did work on, and he and the mother, remember, was shot in the church.
Yes. She was shot on his birthday, by the way.
Okay.
I'm It is happening.
And we need to be the public interest lawsuit. We need some public interest young and present lawyers to not accept the base of the good life that is really dropping you down in our basement. They just said that on Fox News the other day. I need to go back and look at it again because even people that I initially thought it was, but you can join the matrix and think that life is fine, or you can join the struggle at this age where kids turn 12 and find a job in the neighborhood. Yes, sir.
University of Raleigh, and I was privileged to get to vote for you twice in 96 and 98 as a young freshman and junior at college. So all you did in public life and still in public service, it's just so great to hear from a real elected official who you can rely on, and of course that's why they did everything they did to you. And thank you, Mr. Judge. I have a question that goes not as deeply into the systemic, theoretical everything you've done so beautifully. And I want to go back to the first assassination attempt on Dr. King. That kind of predated the acceleration of the 60s, and it was the so-called deranged woman and near kind of the Audubon Ballroom, I guess, in Harlem, as I recall. What do you know about that? And I have the official story. Crazy black woman tries to stab Martin Luther King and fails. Is there more to that? To your knowledge?
I didn't do detailed work on it, but
I'm saying that it's not very normal, but I'm not in program, and it's not your argument around the house, but I'm in California, and if you use any programming, you can't even get a firing line. And then we talk about the and the food, and you can see the shipments, you can see what we can find on the people. And so they're no one doing some attempt to turn this person in some way. There were people in this place that followed John Lennon around with Ray Jones, as kind of a UFO contact. He's possibly ecstasy, but he's been fighting this fight as well. But they had.
Because they are under the influence of these drugs, and that is one of the things that I was looking into from my report and what I can bring you here was the fourth explanation of our changes and what the changes were that were given in the second contract and what exactly our revenue limit would be for us to accept. And we know that the program for assassination is part of what the military wants to have the national people to do with the program.
After him, we just celebrated the 20th with Sonia Sotomayor. One of his last great cases was on MK Ultra, and we showed for our RAL lecture, I think maybe the 8th, the Canadian broadcast company's film, The Sleep Room, which was a docudrama into this. So lest you think it's just our guests here today, this law school has a long experience with these kinds of programs.
Knocked me off my train.
I'm sorry.
Remember what I was saying? Anyway,
beginning in the Vietnam.
Oh, Vietnam. They started to retrain the troops.
Normal human response back in when the veterans came home. So we have a rise in the levels of violence. In the 70s, when they started the battered women's shelter, I went and talked to some of the feminists and the women that were working on it, and they said that 95% of the women were the wives, the spouses, and girlfriends of food. Military, veterans, troops. The people that are starting to do violence in the society were the ones that predominantly being beat. And so if they train you into violence and they make it, giving you this way out. It's like in the high schools. Here, I go in the high schools to counter the military recruiters, and they have a metal detector at the front door, and then, because people need a job, they don't need that mess. They need to go to college, and they don't need to go to the military to get it, especially in the color. But they, they have a metal detector at the front door.
Abortion population control and considers population control as a type of political assassination in as much as it deals with the population of any given group or population.
I have, and I feel that there's levels of mass assassination and genocide that go on and are accepted just as bad policy, but are clearly...
And so, the and his eventually got led to the next step, which is he's been over there, so he's here, the chairman of the family, the president of the board. His wife had a lady of living with her, the vision made from there, you know, they would be taking that space. The first people said that all of that really might be unique, and they were not the political opponents, and even the enrollment of the people, they were medical. They were considered to be users of the society. And what the biggest is that all this is about the same thing.
Talk about population control, they generally don't need people who look like them. that you think you look like us. Well, thank you very much. Thank you.